Hello and welcome to Akshu's Kitchen. Today we'll see how to prepare wheat paratha, for which you will need the following ingredients to prepare approximately 8 to 10 parathas: 2 cups of wheat flour, 1.5 teaspoons of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, and 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda or soda salt, and 1 medium sized egg. First, in a large bowl, I am going to transfer all the ingredients: the wheat flour, the 2 cups of wheat flour, the sugar, baking soda or the soda salt, the salt, and the 1 medium sized egg, and finally 1 tablespoon of oil, any refined oil, sunflower oil or canola oil or vegetable oil or any oil of your choice. And I'm going to mix all these ingredients well together first without adding any water. Once these are all mixed up well, I'm going to add enough water to make a soft dough. Today I'm using a stand mixer to knead the dough, but if you don't have this, you can knead it with your hands like you knead for your chapati. So once this is done, I'm going to take this out and I'm going to prepare into small balls. So the consistency is, it should not be very thick, at the same time it should not be very loose, it should not be very sticky. It should be a little moisture, at the same time not too thick. If you punch it, it should be very soft. So now I have prepared small sized balls out of this, and I'm going to pour about 3 to 4 tablespoons of refined oil over the top and allow it to sit for about an hour. Unlike the normal parotta, wheat parotta can be prepared right away, but I am giving it a little time so that it becomes a little more soft. So once it's time to prepare the parattas, I'm going to roll it out one by one. I'm going to use some oil to grease the worktop and roll it into a very thin parotta first, very thin layer, and then I'm going to peel it out of the worktop, combine it using your fingers on the top, and then circle it in your palm like this and allow it to rest in your worktop until you finish all the rounds like this. So once all the parottas are rolled up, I am going to again roll it out using a rolling pin to the size of a small chapati, approximately 10 cm in diameter, and now you can see it is ready to go on the pan. I am going to add about 1/2 tablespoon to 3/4 tablespoon of oil in a very hot pan and add the rolled out paratha to it. Give it about a minute or two until it starts giving light bubbles, and then I am going to add another 1/2 tablespoon of oil, and then I am going to flip it to the next side. So for each side I am going to add a minimum of 1/2 tablespoon of oil so that it gets fried well in that oil and gives a good texture. Always use a medium flame and cook it until you get good golden brown color on both these sides, and wheat paratha is ready to serve. It's excellent with any non-veg or vegetarian kurma, and it is a healthy alternative for the normal or usual maida paratha. Try it and you will really like it. Thank you for watching Akshu's Kitchen.